It's okay, buddy. It's okay, Samson. Hey, buddy. You're okay, big guy. Good boy. No, just some. I think more nervous horses are the ones that tend to start sweating before the others. If you look at, like, No Name, he's thin-skinned and kind of nervous. You know, he's got a lot of high energy in him and stuff, too, and their breed. Typically, giraffes are supposed to be laid back, but I think it's more because somebody has mistreated him when he was younger, like they were talking about. Move his hindquarters around too with just your body, like, you know, asking him to like poke your finger into his belly, and you can work on that kind of stuff too. There you go. And then, you know, you can do that and like switch deal. That gets him prepared for like spurs and stuff. And that way it don't startle him when you put a leg into him when you get on. Yeah, there you go. And you always do it both ways. That way he learns the feel on both sides. You can still do what you're doing. I was just offering that as a suggestion. Sometimes when they're flighty about getting off your hand, you know, that works a little better for some.
See how he puts his head down for me?
Yep.
He's like, oh, you're going to pet me?
Yeah, and lowering the stirrups where you can kind of do it, even if it don't fit you perfect, but that'll help you to doing the step up, step on part. Another thing is I think we should really work on the putting a mountain block in the center and teaching him to lead over and letting you get over it and then kind of hovering over him. The mounting blocks will help you do like the human currycomb thing and all that. Yeah. I did that on mules, and you just get them okay with you standing beside them and rubbing all over them with or without a saddle, laying all over them and stuff. And believe it or not, it'll really help with that trust issue. Because they look at it with you being above them as, hey, she's going to lay on me and scratch my back. And then they figure it out that you're not trying to hurt them. squeeze his tendon. Is that just a smooth sliding gag? Is that just a smooth sliding gag? The big one that's a sliding smooth one? Yeah. Okay. I'm gonna start fixing his mane. Huh? I said I wanna start braiding his mane where that top part'll lay over up there.
Yeah, it's kinda wild.
And condition it a little bit where it looks better. There's a horse on Facebook, a big old Percheron, looks just like him. A little bit rony, and they're wanting $5,500 for him, but they say he's good for any kid rides and drives. Yeah. Thought about it. I hate to spend that money till we get some more money coming in.
Good boy. Good boy.
Sure as I do. Then a truck or something will break down or something, you know.
I'm fixing to run rain if you want to video that too.
Yeah. I want
to
hit them some more with some more warmer.
Yeah.
The two, the gelding and the mare, because they look like they're getting better, but I'd like to hit them again just in case.
You know who he's friends with?
Who?
That smallest little Palomino colt.
That's funny.
He rears up and plays with him. The colt does with him.
Yeah.